How's it going, guys? Lord Asmore, I'm back. In the last episode, we finished the retopology stage of my character. This is the clothes for the retopology. So now I'm going to go over into Maya and mirror it over so that we can have a finished, not just half retopology clothing, I guess would be the right term for it. So, all right, cool. So let's get to it. So last I did export. I exported the OBJ. So let's see what that got us. Let's go over to Maya and check out our product. Some groovy music. Groovy tunes. So let's get this started. File, import. Close. Okay. F. I'm gonna turn off this grid again. I hate the grid. Just looks dumb. Okay, sweet. So, what do we got here? The few changes that I wanted to do. One of them I remember was in the back of the pants area. This is This part was too far in. I'm going vertex and shoot it up a little bit. That should be bueno. On the edges, I'm just gonna make sure everything is even. I'm gonna do that basically. So you just grab all the vertices and then you pull. See if I can get the actual side view. There we go. That'll give me an actual accurate angle. And that should be it. And that's just clipping because it's very thin. So I'm just gonna bring these in a bit. That sounds like an awkward seesaw. Like from like a horror movie or something. All right, cool. That looks fine. Okay. Now I'm gonna kind of bring this down a little bit. Of just fixing up the mesh a little bit to kind of make it look good before I mirror it over. Now, remember what I said about this glove was I'm gonna add fake depth to it, so edge. Grab the entire edge and then extrude. R for the pull in scaling. Okay. And have it come in a little bit so it looks more like a it's part of the material. Same thing for this one. Double click on edge and extrude. Right, that's reading strange. Okay, so that's why it still had that edge selected. Well, not double click on the edge, you click on the one next to it. So then extrude. R to scale. Alright, so scale it up and then upwards. Gonna do that with all the fingers. Extrude. R. Extrude, R, in, up, extrude, R, in, up, last one, extrude, R, in, up. Right, cool. So we have our glove looking good. I remember I was going to extrude this out. Not extrude really, just pull it out. So I'm gonna grab all of those and then not that far. It's looking better. And I see some areas like this that just pull those out. Okay, so that was looking good. I think the mask was fine. And the boot, I think, is fine too. So, all right, we're in good shape. That was my optimization for that. So now I go over to mesh, mirror. And my mirror, it already snaps the vertices. So now it's all going to be one. And, let's check this out. So everything except for the metal area right here, I want to be oh, actually, hold on, what's going on here? Think that one's a little bit off. That might have happened just now. Let's bring that down. All right. All right. So everything except for the metal, I want to be smoothed. And so, the The way to do that, I'm going to go ahead and where is it? Modeling toolkit, separate. That should separate each individual island piece. All right, so now that we have that, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and define some edges, right? So these edges I want to be harder. I could have done this before I mirrored it, but it's not a big deal. Didn't take very long to do. Me see what's going on here, though. I'm not a fan of what looks like here. I guess my fill hole doesn't like working. So, gonna extrude this edge. Vert. Let's bring this guy up. Okay, and this guy. Okay. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and just select all of these. Shift, right click, soften, soften edges. So now this looks all nice and soft. Those areas start to look like pockets, and you have the belt loop areas, and the boots are looking pretty nice. Have those like those edges I was looking for. The shirt's looking pretty good. All right, so yeah, now the last thing is just this. I'm gonna see how it looks when I do shifts soften. And see, the problem with that is the goggles they shouldn't look soft. And so I'm going to go to harden these edges. Back in edge mode. I'm just gonna Select the edges on the outer side of this. There we go. Harden edge. See? Now it looks like it has some like hardened depth and everything to it. Cool. Looks like this shirt lots of smooth, so I must have had that selected still. Soften. There we go. Alright, so that's looking good. I mirrored it over, softened and hardened certain edges. Okay. See, seen as. Girl. Girl. Close. Okay. Sweet. Export all. Draw close. All right, sweet. Now can. Yeah, I just saved it. Okay, cool. I guess it does that every time you exit out of it. Okay, so this is back in 3D coat, but I want to do one more thing before I do this. I'm gonna go into ZBrush. So here's my ZBrush model so far. Doing pretty good, I think. And let's go ahead and import. So this was what I used before. So I'm going to go ahead and import. Girl clothes. All right, look how low poly that is. Hooray! Good things. Awesome. Well, I'm pretty happy with the results so far. Most of this was done on stream today. Sweet. Look kind of cool with the orange too. I like that. All right, let me show you guys what I'm making for those that don't know what I'm actually doing. So this is the character reference. This is all I had for reference. And then let's see. Samples, turn off spotlight projection. Okay, so yeah, this is all I had for reference so far. One thing that I need to still add is a belt, or the belt, I should say. And then like these glasses. Let me see if I can actually lower this. No, I'll just do these. So, let me duplicate. Z remesh on half. Let's just try to get. If this doesn't work, then I'll just do it myself. This would just, it's just a flat plane, so it'd be cool if it worked. turn off adapt. That's fine. So let's turn off the high poly, and that looks fine. Okay. The same thing with the eyes. Duplicate. Z remesh the eyes. Make sure this is a duplicate. Yeah. Okay, keep on doing it. Okay, looks all right. So let me solo this. Okay, awesome. Lots of things are looking good. Here's the belt. Oh, cool. So I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this belt. And then a lower as my low poly. And that looks really good, actually. That's exactly what I would end up doing anyway. Okay, so let me solo this. I don't need this back face, though. So I'm going to turn off this back face. See if this works. Split unmasked. Me turn on my other. That's not really wanting to work. I'm gonna just go split by parts. Split groups. There we go. So that's the edge. I'll keep the edge. Okay, and so that's the inner side. I don't need this, so I'm going to delete this. And then I'm going to merge down. So now I have the edge and I have the outer end. And then there we go. That's all we need for the bake. Right, I think that is everything. The only thing that Yeah, I don't think we're gonna change this at all because that'd take a long time to retopologize, and it's already pretty low for what it is to keep its shape and everything, so we're gonna keep that the same. Right, and there's the suspender pieces, and then those other small extra pieces. And that's it. So these suspenders and these extra pieces, I will smooth out in Maya before I bake and everything. Bake these pieces. So, but in the meantime, I think it's looking pretty solid. So, okay. The last thing that we need is teeth. Let's go ahead and re and and get. Let's go ahead and get this done first, though. So now we need to just UV everything, right? So let's UV everything. Oh, real quick, that's the reason I brought everything in here was first I wanted to make sure that everything evened out properly. So let's go ahead and get the high poly out. So here's the high poly shirt, right? And so now I'm going to kind of move some of these things so it bakes right. So I'm taking symmetries off, right? Just make sure that these things fill in these spaces. Like they're supposed to. So I use symmetry, but now I'm moving them without symmetry so that the wrinkles and all those things, it'll just kind of fit. You could UV this first if you wanted to, but I just want to do this before. That won't affect the UVs when you move things like this. Okay, that's looking pretty good. So, I needed to adjust a few of these parts as well. To make the low poly bigger than the high poly, so that when you cage it, it'll look fine. It'll bake okay. I don't want to pass in the belt though, because that's going to make the belt weird. That's looking pretty good. And then the boots. Just gonna do a clay build up. Just kidding, I'm not gonna do that. Inflate. Should have done that before. I want to like just move in everything individually. Inflate does just fine. I'm not gonna mess with this actually, the boots. I feel like they're. Like they'll be okay. All right, so I think that's everything now. Cool. All right, so now we have the whole low poly character. I'm not worried about this armband thing. It'll be fine without it. So, yeah, now let's retabo it all. So, going to solo this. And I think I'm gonna have this part separate. So, split, unmasked. So, just the clothes, right? So, the clothes. Split, unmasked. Export girl clothes. Gonna have clothes on one. I'm gonna have skin on another one, and then I'm gonna have like the top on another one because it's like metallic and leather and that kind of stuff. And I wouldn't always do this way. Like you could have a character on one if you use Substance Painter and would just masked out what would be rough and leather that kind of thing, and metal and everything. But because I'm just doing this with your marmoset, I'm gonna have it just skin. Yeah, skin metal. even eyes will have its own. So. So let's yeah, let's get to 3D coat. New. UV map. Let's superhero clothes. All right, so you're given this N3D coat. This is your kind of like your startup, right? So with this, I never keep this. So clear seams and clear clusters, and now it just on. It kind of keeps this information, right? Then I do unwrap again, and it just does bleh right here. So we gotta start somewhere. So biggest thing about UVing is what's 45 degrees and what's not. So already, you want to do like work with the sleeves, because this is a tube-like area, and a lot of times you'll see people, you'll have a seam here. So we'll have a seam at the bottom. You want to have seams a lot of times where you're not going to be able to see them, and then because it's the tube, I just make it around this section where the tube ends. See how I have the topology where it's like that, and then bam, it's that easy. Oop, that's right. I had a few adjustments. So let me go through here. Okay, I think actually would it be this? Oh, I see what I did. Okay, so I'll do this. It's not as clean as I like it to be, but it's okay. Or actually, I know what I'll do. Let's go in. Okay, so now I have this the sleeve area. Okay. So I can do the same to the other side. Let's see. So it was. And then front two, and then here, yeah. Pretty sure that's looking right. Let's do for five. That's pretty close. So I'm gonna go ahead and unwrap again. Just cleaning up that. Now I'm gonna add seams to the top. It's because you have to. So here and there we go. So that way you have the front and back base. Unwrap again. And yeah, the shirt. Back sleeve. Oh, this I forgot to add the so let's add, there we go, the seam on the sleeve. So now I have both sleeves, front and back. All right. It's pretty easy, huh? Hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Marcore US Gamer. Working in 3D coat right now. So I get a little bit into it, so I sometimes I don't realize someone's messaging me right away. Probably should have better notification noise for that. I'm just getting into the live stream things. But yeah, thanks for coming to the stream. Currently UVing in 3D coat. So. Okay. So anything that's past the like this degree, right? You want to go ahead and make that its own island. So like this area. Let's go ahead and add that quick seam down the middle. And then with this, I'm gonna go ahead and just make it the pocket zones. There we go. Okay, yeah, so there we go. Let's see how this looks. Unwrap. Cool, so now the only thing that looks messed up is the gloves and boots. So yeah, this is the back of the pants and the front. And then so now we can do the boots and the gloves. All right. So yeah, all these cap pieces, you want to make this its own planes, its own UV areas. All right. So when it comes into hands, try to have a flow of let's see here. These kind of cap pieces you don't really need. If you have any questions about my process or what I'm doing, just holler. Any of the keys I'm doing or something like that, maybe. Okay, so right now I'm just finding my seams. And that's part of the topology process that I did before. I'm just, I have those weird areas, right? So now that's gonna really help me in this process. So those in between square things. And then this last one, just the palm. Oh, I forgot this bit right here. Bam, there we go. Looking solid. So let's do the same to the other side. I probably could have put symmetry on for this part right here. That was my fault. But that's okay. I kind of know what I did. Okay, so find that middle seam. Middle seam. And the one that follows to here. There we go. Palm. Okay. So thinking. Okay, so that's there we go. Hooray! Now we have the gloves. Nice and UV'd. Okay, Alright, first off, I didn't want to do that, so let's control Z that shit. Unwrap. There we go. So you have all those solo islands over in this corner. Looks like one of them I accidentally, probably just one of them. Yeah. Well. Okay. Unwrap. Okay, let's see. Okay, that's the inside right here. Alright, so last little bit. I am streaming again, what's up? Yeah. I've been like streaming all day. Well, on and off. Oh, well, that makes sense. Okay. Yeah, I was about to message you. Yeah, sorry, I'm really trying to get this this finished. I'm trying to, well, this assignment, I'm trying to do by midnight. And, yeah. So, but luckily I just need to, I'm almost finished UVing, these clothes, and I have some more UVing to do, so I'm probably gonna be the whole time, I'm assuming. I really do need the whole time to finish everything and then pose at the end. So, currently I'm just working hard. Yeah, I've been streaming quite a bit today. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't really know who's all on the stream, but it seems to be going pretty well so far. And I'm exporting the vids to YouTube as well. So that's cool. So I have it on my Lord Asmore channel. Okay, so finished off the bases of the heel areas. And now we're going to find an end seam. So I'm going to do like this because that's a perfect flow to the top. I like the flow of it. Same for this one. Island for the top. Inner island. an island. And then that already has that seam. That has a seam. It's good. Turn off this though. These rings can stay rings. Okay. So I'm gonna unwrap again. Let's see what we got. Okay, that's one of the shoes. I can make something cleaner than that, though. Let's see. I'll s select another edge on. There we go. Let's try to unwrap that. Right, well, this is fully EV'd at this moment. I'm going to be okay with this right now because I'm not really caring about UV type or like UV cleanliness at the moment. So that I'm going to leave it as it is, at least for now. So this is the clothes page, and then I'll have the skin page next, and then you'll have the hat and things like that on last. So matter of fact, I should have added the hat in on this one. Wasn't considering that. That's okay. Okay, so the first, oh, next thing we're gonna do is save. Okay, let's do girl clothes. Right, and then apply UV set. You have to do this for it to export the UVs. Or to save the UVs, yeah. Okay, and then I do export UVs on the texture bar. Export UVs. Girl clothes. Cool. So now it should go in with UVs. So let's find out. Let's go into ZBrush. And then import girl clothes OBJ. Okay, then go to the C plugin UV master and then copy UVs, flatten, and then bam. So copy the UVs from the OBJ, and then it looks good. Looks fine. That's how I did it. Although it's flipped. I don't know why it flips. It just does. It's kind of strange like that. But that doesn't really matter for what we're doing. So, unflatten. There we go. Okay, so what's next? Next, we have the girl skin retopo. I'm gonna export this girl skin retopo OBJ. It's probably fine the way it was, but it's okay. Okay, now we have all the skin pieces. So let's go to new. Oh, yeah, I'll see this out. Here's girl clothes. New, UV, UV map, girl skin, retopo. All right, cool. So same kind of thing. Let's do unwrap. Well, not unwrap, sorry. Clear clusters, clear seams. All right, everything on the skin is symmetric, so I will add symmetry on this one. So symmetry, x-axis. Okay, inner seam. Outer side. Inner seam for legs. We'll do one more back like that. And your legs. The face can be tricky, but the gist of it is I'll do mouth. Save that right there. Cut it in half. Okay. Eyes. It's like raccoon now. Top of the head, one. And then that way it'll stop at that point, and then cut the whole back top of the head. I'll do until this point, kind of like to the forehead zone. No, I'll do to like this point, that forehead area. Okay, I'm gonna unwrap, see how it looks. Looking a little scary. Ears are. Let me check, actually. This is one thing I really like about this software. It's just amazing. See, I'm just smoothing out my UVs. Make my brush size a little bigger. Look at that, it's just so nice. Maya has nothing on 3D coat, at least in this setting. Does the same thing as other way, it doesn't affect the outer edge, it just affects the inside right here. God, that's nice. You'll see it when you stretch it, it's red. So you know what parts are not looking right. Just from seeing if he sees red. Just trying to stretch it so it doesn't look like it's smaller. Because blue means smaller, red means stretched. So kind of do this until all the zones are pretty close to gray. Okay. What part is it's the eye? The eye, I don't want to mess up with it right now because there's something I have to do with it first. This is fine, but I'll just do it anyway. Okay, so what else do we need to do with this? The neck is almost the 90 degree from the jaw area. So let's go ahead and add mark seams. Mark seams for the jawline. I'm back to balance mode and then pick edges again. Okay, so the ears are fine to stay. The neck really isn't bad, like it can actually be where it's at. The only thing that needs to really change is the oh, I need to do the inner legs again. And then the fingers. These fingers. All right, so that should have been on both sides. Yep, cool. That's really all I needed to do, unwrap. One thing I forgot was that when you unwrap, fortunately it resets everything like that, so that's the unfortunate part. But now, everything is really good to go. I might need to adjust a few things, like I don't really care about having all these fingers. Oh yeah, the eyes, that's right, I need to do the eyes real fast. Okay, so, eyes, the main thing is that it has eyelashes, and that's what kind of bunks it up, right? So, in that case, the eyelashes, all they are planes, that's how I set them up as, and so, we're gonna make sure it just reads a different color. All these eyelash zones. That's a bit odd. That's okay. Cool. So now that all the eyelashes are different colors, you know that they're going to bake better. So and I'll do the inner eye. Unwrap. Okay. Now nothing should be warped anymore. You have the random eyelash pieces. Not too sure what these little bits are. Or if they're really anything. Okay, they're all selected because you can see that they have the edges here, and I'm gonna bring them out of the box. Okay, so I'm just gonna select all of these, then bring these closer to these. I just wanna get them all in one area. Just optimizing my UVs in the moment. Oops. Didn't deselect the last ones. See here. Okay, let's select all of these now and bring them back into the main UV area. Okay. Just kind of giving everything its own space a little more. It's not as close in proximity. Plenty of open room here. There we go. And I'm gonna smooth this face out a little bit more again, and then so that's going to be on the brush. Expand my brush some, and then just smooth out. The ears, especially. Okay, so I'm just smoothing these areas out a bit and making it less squashed. Right, cool. So the skin is now finished. Save as. Grill Retopo. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go and save this out. Girl. Apply UVs. Okay. Now I'll go to textures. Export UVs. Girl skin Retopo. Some go juice. All right, go juice. I can go. Okay. Now I can go back to ZBrush and then import. Make sure I'm in the right layer. Girl skin retopo. And it should just replace itself. And then go to Z plugin. Copy UVs. Flatten. Cool. And again, it's flipped, but that's okay. Doesn't really matter. Cool, so that's looking good. Unflatten. So what do we have done right now? We have done the clothes. Minus the strap piece. Let's see here. So I'm gonna do the hair real fast. Let's do a few other pieces, right? So we have the hair, we have this little flower piece, the tongue. Merge down. This hat we need to UV merge down. Merge down. The belt. Merge down. So we have so far tongue, hat, straps, belt. What else? We can do here. We can do Well, eyes. Because everything's gonna be on a gloss, so I want the eyes to be separate on its own little on the little thing. Well, no, the eyes and like the visor actually. We'll keep the eyes and the visor together. There we go. Let's merge down. Eyes and visor will have gloss to them. What else? Me split unmasked. I'm gonna add the flower to the gloss. Merge down. So these will be the glossy areas. Alright, so I need to UV these. Okay. And when I UV them, I can go ahead and hat up so I can UV it properly and not get in the way of the hair. And then I can just bring it back down when I need to. Okay, cool. So, you know what? I'm actually gonna bring the tongue. Split unmasked. I'm gonna bring the tongue in the gloss layer because I want the tongue to be kind of glossy too. Merge down the glossy areas. Not sure that was acting up kind of odd. Whatever. Okay. So. What's going on here? Oh, just. That's okay. Let's see if that worked. Split groups. Okay, now this guy. Can go with the this group. So merge down. Look at the straps and accessories and stuff like that. So I'm going to export this. Straps and hair. Okay. File new. All right, so UV straps and hair. Okay, so clear cluster, clear seams. Let's go ahead and UV these islands. Bam, bam. Unwrap. Let me bring down my draw size a lot. Unwrap. Okay, the belts and straps are looking good, the hat's looking good. Now it's just the hair. The hair doesn't have much rhyme and reason because I didn't retopo it. So it's gonna be a little bit more crazy than the rest was. But that's okay. Okay, where's the ending of this? Okay, so now those hair pieces are looking good. Now it's only the main hair piece that we need to figure out. Okay. This hair is going to be a beast. This might be more frustrating than I thought for the hair anyway. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to accept the UVs for everything except for the hair. So let's go ahead and save these out. Straps. Okay. Let's go back to ZBrush. Import straps in here. Z plugin, copy UVs, flatten. Okay. It's looking good. Unflatten. Let's get rid of the hair pieces. Okay, so this. Merge down. Let's see if it kept the UVs. I hope it did. Yep, okay, so that's just fine. These are gonna be the straps and hat layer, basically. This is gonna be the hair. I'm just gonna retopo this really fast, and this will be the last thing I retopo. It just sounds creepy. New. Straps. Straps. Reachability. Here for retop. Okay, let's make this quick. Really didn't care to retopologize this, but it needs to be done. Quads. So I'm just gonna follow the perimeter. Fortunately, here you don't need to do the bulk of it, right? You just need to do the outside. This hair is flat, right? So. So make sure you get the outside shapes. Some parts that you want to get the bulk of it, but it's not like you do the front and the back. It's kind of counterintuitive. So I'm gonna do the outside, and I'm gonna do like the things you're gonna see, right? The sides and the outside mostly. Not going to see up there, so there's no point in doing it. You want to definitely have less UVs. You're not going to see something, then there's no point of having it. Sounds like a mixture between like Congo and horror. That's very interesting. Well, that was weird. Right. Doing the edge work. Oh man. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Okay, let's see. Still way better than doing hair cards. Hair cards for realistic hair is a pain. This is just kind of like retopoing random blob or something. Just weird. But it's better than doing hair cards on for sure. Rather this any day than hair cards. Start getting more of the meat of it finished. It sounds like a Bowser Castle audio to me. Or like a 90s montage. Montage music is kind of perfect for this setting, though. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Starting to look like something. Thanks for hanging out with me, Will. Yeah, I figure your plan. I would be if I didn't have this assignment. But this is top priority at the moment. I shouldn't have waited so long to complete so much, but oh well. I mean, I was working on it for a while, especially the high poly, so I mean, gonna give myself a break. I was doing decent, and but probably should have worked on a little bit of this more. Okay. I'm using strokes for these hair pieces. Hopefully strokes works for me this time. It should, because this isn't a hollow object. So hopefully it'll be working the way it should. Okay, so something's wrong with strokes, I think. This is just annoying today with strokes. Oh well, I'm just wasting a little more time, but it's okay. At least I know I'm not, I can't use it. So, that being the case, one poly at the start. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Let's get this shit done. Thank you. This is the reason why I didn't want to retop it with the hair. This takes forever. I was like, hey, I just want to make it lower poly. Okay. Okay, looking good so far. I think that may have been it on my hair. So let's see here. Not sure we'll be able to fully see on this. I'm gonna go ahead and add. That's probably solid. Okay, so that's fine. That's all I'm gonna do with the hair. Well, no, I'm gonna add just a little bit, one more edge on here. So again, I'm just not really sure how much you'll be able to see. All right, that looks fine. All right, so I'm gonna save this out. Save as. Here. New. Gonna go ahead and just quickly UV it. I picked the. I know what I did. I need to export. I just saved, I didn't export. That's okay. Go ahead and get out of this. Keep it going. Okay. Export retopo object. There we go. Here for retopo. All right. New UV here for retopo. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll be at work soon. That's what I'm trying to finish. Alright, so let's quickly UV the sucker. Okay, so that is one of the inside islands. Let's find some more inside islands. Let's do that first. Okay, that's an inside island. This will be an inside island as well. That's not attached, but that's okay. It's only because it's not gonna be seen. Be seen. If you're gonna be able to see that, that wouldn't be okay. However, you could still snap it, the vertices in Maya if you wanted to. So you want to dissect this kind of thing in chunks. So let's make it. Let's make it chunks. So almost everything else seems okay except for it's the main bulk of the hair. So then it's just that bottom part that needs to be finished up. So I go ahead and Single out these areas. Almost like fingers in a way. And this piece. So it's just this chunk now. Wrap. There we go. Alright. So that's going to be okay. So now apply UVs. Save that out. Girl hair. Textures. Export UVs, hair free topo. Hair free topo. Okay. Okay, there's something else I need to. Okay, free topo. There we go. Hair and straps, I did that. What else needs to be done? Okay. Okay. Girl. Skin low. Girl skin high. Okay, so now I'm bringing the skin up so that you can't see that it's not a full arm. The skin areas I just need to stretch out. The metal and the gloss areas are the ones that I haven't finished just yet, so that's the last things I need to do. Metal blue. Gloss low. Gloss low. Okay, UV. I'll do middle low first. Okay, then the belt. Belt buckle real fast. We're almost done UVing everything. I think if real life had a sanity meter, I'd be off the charts. Just be like, ugh. Been on this so long now. Okay, so that's fixed. Now it's just the. What's this? Why does it look problematic? That shouldn't be. Okay, so let me tweak this to figure out what's going on. There we go, just had to go inside the mesh and fix that. Cool. That's all I needed to do. Yeah, it's a bit odd. That's okay. Main thing is that I got that fixed so it's on a flat. Which is what we want. Okay, so the metal is finished. Unwrap everything. Cool. All right. So apply UV sets. Save as metal. Okay. Textures, export UV. Metal low.